accepted.
What's up, you two friends? It's me, Mr. HackHappy, and I'm back with part two of installing Kali into Windows. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the, basically enable the Linux subsystem via the GUI. I've had more than a few questions about that. So let's get started with that. I'm going to show you how to set up the subsystem using the graphical user interface with inside Windows. So you're going to open up your Windows settings, and then you're going to browse to update and security. Now, once you get here, you're going to select the developers on the left. And then at the top, you will select developer mode. Now, when you click that, you're going to get this window that's asking you, do you want to do this? You're going to say, yes, give it to me. I want developer mode now. And then you wait impatiently. And now what we need to do is open up the Windows features. And once you have this window loaded, you'll then scroll down. And then you'll place a check mark next to the Windows subsystem for Linux. Click OK. And it's going to do its thing. And then again, just sit here and wait impatiently. All right, it's done. And guess what? We get to reboot once again. All right, I'm back again. Rebooted, back in my desktop. All right, so now, let's just open a command prompt. And from this point, you have two options. You can simply type bash and go through the installation process, or you can do the lxrun/install, as I showed you in the last video, to just automatically install bash. Well, since the last time I did the lxrun, this time I'm going to do the manual install. So I'm just going to type bash. I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to tell it yes to continue. And here we go. Okay, now it's asking us for a Unix username. And there you have it. Your Linux subsystem in Windows. So that's that part. I just wanted to illustrate that because I had several people asking how exactly to do that, because I guess they were having some problems doing it via the scripts. So that's all there is to it. It's pretty simple to do it that way as well. So how do you run your XWindows programs on your Windows system? Well, it's pretty simple. Once you have the Linux subsystem installed, all you need to do is install this Windows application called XMing. And it is a free program. Just go to Google and type XMing. That is X-M-I-N-G, homie. And it will be the first link. Click download. Go ahead and execute the download. We'll click next, next, yes, We'll leave all the defaults. I'm happy with that. Feel free to do what you like. And install. Alright, once it's finished installing, simply click finish. And you can always check in your system tray to see if it's running. Alright, once Xming is installed and running, you're going to come back to your Windows shell. So actually, let's just go ahead and make command shell open. And once you have a command shell open, simply type bash. And this will load up the Linux subsystem. And now from here, what you need to do is you need to export your display. That way it will go to your Xming server and allow it to display in Windows. So let's do that now. And you just simply type this command. Actually, it should be display, not displat. And I'm very much insisted on displat. Okay, export display equals colon zero. Hit enter, done. All right, so now let's install some sort of XWindows program. Let's just install Firefox. That's gonna be a doozy. Okay, I do not have Firefox on my system, I just have Chrome. So I'm going to now install the Linux version of Firefox into my Linux subsystem. And then execute or run Firefox, again, the Linux version, via my Linux subsystem through the Xming server that I have running on my Windows system, thus allowing me to run an XWindows program in Windows. Wow, that was a mouthful. Okay, so we're just gonna let this install. Once it's installed, we're gonna come back, we're gonna execute it, and we will be done. Okay, now that we have Firefox installed, and we have already set our display, and just to recap, in case you've been clicking around the video, all you have to do is type the following command. There goes displat again. Display. And just execute this command. And that's all you need to do. And now your XWindows programs will run, assuming you have all the proper packages and everything you need to actually run them. So let's go ahead and just type Firefox. And since I'm actually not working in my main display, it opened in the other window. But here you can see Ubuntu, the Linux version of Firefox on my Windows PC. So there you have it. It's that simple. You just merely install the Xming, install your XWindows programs, and run them. So there you go, guys. Finally, I have got that video done for you. I have several other videos I'm working on right now. I'm working on a new Python video, and this is kind of going to be a big one in the sense that I think I'm going to cover a few different topics in the same video. Actually, I'll probably end up breaking it up into multiple, but what we're going to do is we're going to build a GUI program in Python. So we're going to learn how to actually make a cross-platform GUI application in Python. And I think what we'll do is we'll make like a front end to end map. Ooh, or maybe what we could do is I was going to make a front end to something, but actually, no, I forgot. I had already decided what I'm going to do. We're going to make a GUI version of our source code analyzer. So that's what's going to be coming up. I also have a capture the flag I'm going to do. I might do a couple. So yeah, I got a bunch of stuff coming up. Finally got this one out of the way. So hey guys, if you like this video, please subscribe. Please give me a thumbs up. I do greatly appreciate it. It motivates me to make new videos. And if you have any friends, I don't know what friends are, but if you have any friends whom you think might like my videos, by all means, please share them with them. And I will see you on the other side.
Login acceptance.